so much for joining us this morning. I am just thrilled to be here today because we are going to celebrate the opening of the largest biogas facility in the United States, and that's a pretty cool thing. I should introduce myself. My name is Katherine Sorenson. I'm the director of Phoenix Water Services. Thank you again so much for joining us here today. We're thrilled to have all of our partners with us. I think you guys all know that the 91st Avenue Wastewater Treatment Plant facility where we are, it is jointly owned by the cities of Phoenix, Tempe, Scottsdale, Glendale, and Mesa. We are very grateful for this partnership. Would not be successful in our endeavors without them. To get things kicked off this morning, I'm going to ask Phoenix Mayor Kate Gallego to come up and give us some opening remarks.
Thank you to Katherine, our Rockstar Water Services Director. I am excited to be with you here today. I am Kate Gallego, and today is my 5-week anniversary as the mayor of Phoenix. Before I was mayor, I had the pleasure of serving on the Phoenix City Council and chairing the council's sustainability subcommittee, so it is very exciting for me to be here today. I was lucky enough to be present at the groundbreaking, and it is wonderful to be at the finish line. This is the week in which we celebrate Earth Day, and how fitting that this is also the week we cut the ribbon on the largest biogas facility of its kind in the entire country. A huge congratulations to Amoresco and the entire construction team on getting us to this very important milestone. Thank you to folks like Meg Leal, who were there with us at the beginning and worked with us to make the project happen. It also could not have happened without our partner cities, and we are grateful that Councilwoman Solange Whitehead from the city of Scottsdale is here today. She is a major advocate on sustainability and a great partner for us at the city of Phoenix. We have a broad vision for our region. We want to be known for sustainability, and the more we can work together, the better. The voters in the city of Phoenix approved a 10-year plan and said that we would move towards being the most sustainable desert city on the entire planet. Today's milestone is a very important part of moving forward in that area. The amount of greenhouse gases that are avoided because of this facility producing renewable energy is the equivalent of taking 70,000 vehicles off the road each year, so we'll be improving renewable air quality and moving towards our ambitious goals on renewable energy. Before I was a city councilwoman, I served as the chair of the Environmental Quality Commission when we kicked off our city's vision to move towards more renewable energy, so it is personally exciting on my 5-week anniversary to be with you here today as we have our largest project that will move us towards that goal. It is the carbon reduction, more than 44,000 metric tons of CO2 per year, equivalent of more than 10,000 households heated for 1 year, or 2,000 rail cars worth of coal burned. So a huge environmental impact and something that is a point of pride for our entire region. Thank you to Tempe, Scottsdale, Glendale, and Mesa for partnering with us on this important project. And I want to thank you for celebrating Earth Week with us here today. This area is represented by Councilman Michael Nowakowski, who is here with us today, and I want to welcome him up to the podium.
Well, good morning, everyone. It's exciting, right? Not number two, not number three, but we have the number one plant in the country. Not in Arizona, but in the whole country. That's really exciting. And that's what happens. All right. Mother Nature's excited too, right, Mayor? And that's what happens when we really work what I call the Team Phoenix approach, where we work with all the different cities that own a piece of this 91st Avenue facility. And it's when we work with our business partners, our community partners, like Abisko, that really made this all possible. And thank you all for your hard work and making this a dream come true for all of us. So why is it a dream come true? It's really going to help us to make sure that everything that goes into this plant is recyclable. It's either going to be recyclable through using it in our wetlands here or through fuel. We're going to recycle everything that comes out of here, 100% of everything that comes out of here. And this is all possible because of our partnerships with the city of Scottsdale, Tempe, Glendale, and Mesa. And everyone involved will bring this project to completion. So thank you all for everything you've done out here. Next, I really want to thank Briscoe for everything that they've done. And I'd like to introduce a person that has been very vocal and that met with me several times and most of the council. I know that with Kate also when she was a council member, to tell us about this dream and about how this project's going to happen. And now it's here. So what I call him is Jaime Cerveza. In English, that would be called Jim Beer. Come on down.
Well, I think it's appropriate that I'm called Jaime Cerveza because I moved to Mexico earlier this year. So thank you, Councilman. I think the agenda said that Mike Backus was going to speak, and he was challenged getting here via travel. But he's certainly not challenged writing and delivering amazing speeches. So I'm going to do my level best to make sure that I can express his sincere gratitude for everybody that's here today, and then also for all the people that work behind the scenes to build this project. I'm honored and humbled to stand here today to celebrate the operations of the largest renewable energy project of its kind in the U.S. The timing of this could not have been better. So I thought it was Earth Day on Monday, but I guess we can call it Earth Week. So with that in the background, and then the current state of affairs of our climate, I think it's very appropriate that we're here today. The Chinese have a word for crisis, and it's composed of two picture characters. One is the meaning of danger. The other one is the meaning of opportunity. In its fifth assessment report in the International Government Panel on Climate Change, a group of 1,300 independent scientists from countries all over the world concluded that human activity over the last 50 years has warmed our planet. The industrial activities that our modern civilizations depend upon have raised the carbon dioxide levels by 43% in the last 150 years. Earth orbiting satellites and technology advances have enabled us to see the big picture on a global scale. And this body of evidence and data collected over many years reveals signals of a changing climate, a crisis. The planet's average temperature has risen 1.6 degrees Fahrenheit since the late 19th century. Most of this warming has taken place in the last 35 years, with the five last years being the warmest on record. Now, when Mike did this, this goes on and on. There's definitely danger. There's another page and a half of the dangers that climate change is happening in our world today. So I think it's fair to say that our environment today is in a state of crisis. But as I noted earlier, there's opportunity within crisis. The City of Phoenix and SHROG members made a voluntary decision to act. And that decision, this commitment to climate change, or to doing something about climate change, is why we're here today. This renewable energy project takes the raw biogas generated at the 91st Avenue Wastewater Treatment Plant and processes it into a pipeline quality gas that is fully interchangeable with a conventional fossil fuel called natural gas. This renewable natural gas can then be blended for use as a transportation fuel in the form of compressed natural gas, displacing a fossil fuel. In the process of doing this, we accomplished many positive things. Again, Mike went on and on, I'll share a few of them. It captures the wasted energy. Prior to us being here, the gas was being flared. So we're collecting a wasted gas and we're piping it off-site, thereby improving the local air quality. It displaces a fossil fuel in the transportation sector, creates new revenue for the city of SHROG, or the cities under SHROG, reduces operational cost. In our groundbreaking, Mike quoted a French author who said, "Man cannot discover oceans unless he has the courage to lose sight of the shore." I want to recognize and applaud all those individuals who chose to venture from their comfort zone and work tirelessly with Ameresco to make this project successful, extracting an opportunity from crisis. A special thanks to all the staff of the SHROG cities. I want to give a special shout out to Dennis Porter, Stefan Witherall, Patty Kennedy, Jeff Cooey, Blaine Akini, Stephanie Bracken, Ron Surio, Mark Roy. Their passion for this project ensured that this project was a success and is a success. We feel very fortunate to be here today to celebrate their success. I also want to give a special recognition to one of our important business partners, Element Markets, represented here today by Tom Moffitt. They are responsible for taking this market to gas and maximizing the revenue for all Sauk cities and Ameresco. I also wanted to recognize the Ameresco team, Bill Slack and Jacinta Doma, who are responsible for designing and constructing this facility, Adam Atkins and Andrew Hartman, who are in the back, and they're gonna give a tours later if anybody's interested in giving a tour. They're here 24/7 ensuring that this project meets our expectations. And again, just a sincere thanks from all of us. And with that, I would like to introduce a good friend and a real advocate for the renewable natural gas industry, Johannes Escudero. He's the CEO and Executive Director of the RNG Coalition. Please join me in welcoming Johannes.
Thank you, Jim, and thank you to everyone. As the founder and CEO of the Coalition for Renewable Natural Gas, which is a nonprofit organization that coalesced the industry in 2011 to build a policy platform and to amplify an advocacy and education voice for the renewable natural gas industry in North America, what you see as a backset to our speeches this afternoon or this morning are proof positive of what can happen when citizens come together to collectively pool our resources, our experience, and our wisdom, and make a difference in the world that's lasting, that's evident. And so renewable natural gas, as you know, is raw biogas that is methane, essentially, as organic materials in our waste streams decompose naturally. Unless renewable natural gas projects like the one behind us today are developed, and it takes a village to create these opportunities. It's the investment, it's partnerships with the City of Phoenix, Glendale, Tempe, Scottsdale. I'm not from Arizona, so I've probably left someone on the Sauk team out. It takes a developer, an experienced leadership of Ameresco, and it takes their partners, like Element Markets, to take that gas to market to really allow these projects to pencil out. But it wouldn't happen without advocacy. We remind our staff internally that at the end of the day, it's public policy advocacy and education that influences markets. Those markets drive demand. That demand determines the value of a given commodity. In this case, we're celebrating the availability, the increased supply of renewable natural gas. When renewable natural gas is produced and used, whether it's to generate renewable electricity or to provide an ultra-low carbon transportation fuel alternative to diesel and conventional natural gas, we are literally mitigating methane emissions, emissions that occur naturally at wastewater treatment plants. And unless that methane gas is captured, redeemed, illustrating really the epitome of sustainability for a productive and positive end use, it's going to vent, it's going to escape fugitively into the atmosphere as a short-lived climate pollutant, many times more potent even than carbon as a greenhouse gas. And so this is a fantastic testament to what you and I, and together as communities, we can accomplish. When we come together, we can really make a difference. And so we want to thank Ameresco again. We want to thank the City of Phoenix for your tremendous demonstration of leadership here, of persistence over the years to make this project happen. And as the founder of the RNG Coalition, I also have the pleasure and privilege of serving as board of director for Energy Vision, which is a 501c3 environmental advocacy or education group based out of New York. And in recognition of the hard work and the accomplishment and achievement that you have done here at the largest wastewater treatment plant in the Southwest, but also now the largest wastewater to renewable natural gas production facility in the entire United States, we wanted to recognize you for your leadership. And so, Mayor Kate Gallego, if you would join me once again, we'd like to present this award to you. You can open it up. It's not a Pandora's box, I promise. And to symbolize your leadership, your ability to look beyond the challenges of the present, into the environmental and economic benefits for society, into the future in perpetuity, the Leadership Award for the City of Phoenix. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for your support. Thank you, Mayor Gallego.
Thank you again for being here with us today. A lot of names were thrown out there, lots of people to thank. I just want to also thank the folks who work here day in and day out, behind the scenes, to make sure that we safely remove wastewater from our customers' homes, treat it in protection of the environment and public health. They are often unrecognized. They work here behind these secure walls, but what they do is the foundation of how we live here in the Valley of the Sun. So please, a quick shout out to the employees of the 91st Avenue Wastewater Treatment Plant. And then also, just real quickly, I want to say that, you know, these projects, obviously, you heard from these folks here. It takes a lot of partnerships, a lot of leadership, a lot of vision. But we would not be successful in these projects if we did not have elected officials who are willing to take risks. And that's a really big deal. If we did not have elected officials who understand the importance of water here in the desert Southwest, the importance of recycling it, and the importance of always innovating and doing more. So I also want one more thanks to Phoenix Mayor Kate Gallego, Councilmember Michael Nowakowski, and Councilwoman Solange Whitehead, who are all here. Thank you so much for being willing to take risks. And we will now move on to our ribbon cutting ceremony. So if our dignitaries could please join us over there for a photo op, that would be fantastic. Thank you again.